Dude.
We going into it, man?
Okay, forget the intros. Here we go. Sassy versus PTP with Gibbous. Sassy being one of the best players, if not the best player in Austin. Very well known for possessing that excellent, excellent rob. And it's going to be having to get around Gibbous. Gibbous has some rob practicing as Gibbous. He's played a fair share of sets against Gio. But I can't recall for sure what their set count is looking like.
I don't remember either.
And I think if I remember correctly, I think Gio has a slight edge on Gibbous. And so maybe Gibbous might have some troubles with this matchup overall. Okay. Either way, let's see. Different Rob. Let's see how he copes. Game one, Town and City.
So out the gate, you're going to see a lot of jabs, a lot of damage getting flowing left and right from here between the two of them. But the difference is Rob is going to stay alive a lot longer. This character has tons of sustainability because of this super heavy weight. So generally taking him off the top, really difficult. Probably not going to happen. But off the sides, much more likely.
And speaking of the top, that is something that we definitely have to consider, as well as the Robo Hoo-Ha down throw into up air.
That beep boop, homie.
The beep boop. That's going to be utilized by Sassy a lot, especially if he gets the percents higher. But especially whenever the percents are lower, you can expect that top to be utilized as an option to cover so much of the stage. And Sassy maybe even doesn't run the quickest with a character like Rob. But by utilizing that top, it's like an extension of his own hurt boxes. And it makes it so that it's another thing that Gibbous has to deal with in his effort to try to take center stage from Sassy. Just look at him controlling so much with that top and continuing to put on so much pressure. Going for another Robo Hoo-Ha, bites out that air dodge and gets the two stock.
You need to make sure that you condition people early in this game. Because when you get them into those predicaments where you know that the up air is the way to do it, you have to say, okay, the last time I took you pretty consistently by just going directly into it. The second time, they know that's coming. So you have to play that mind game of saying, I'm going to wait, and now I'm going to do it. So being able to know that small amount of reading your opponent, especially when it comes to kill options, is extremely important in this game. Particularly because there's a lot of combo games that go straight from throw into those sort of setups. So it takes a little,
yes,
a little mini game within the main game, right?
Definitely very big. For Gibbous, I think that a big thing was just getting in. He just had a hard time dealing with the top. He struggled.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, Gibbous definitely struggled a bit with dealing with the top, and I think that that's why we're seeing the switch now to Battlefield. Those platforms will give him another means of escape, but Sassy can start picking up on that, potentially getting an early KO if he can get the right read on when he's going to the platform and then having the up air waiting for him as he's there. Sassy, nice. Getting those grabs leading into that up air.
That beat move.
Solid damage already. Another nice grab, another great up air.
Gosh. This damage is just completely compiling. Wow! Read that he wanted to go underneath and said, you know what, I got a down air for you. Ooh, interesting. He had a little bit of charge on there and waited just a moment to see if he'd reacted. So the reason why we talk so much about the top is because having a threat zone that can constantly be moving and shifting is really big deal. Because your opponent has to deal with it in some way, shape, or form. Whether that's avoiding it, whether that's and by jumping over it, whether that's by picking it up, and potentially changing how he has, what he works with it. There's so many different things that come with dealing with this that makes it really problematic. Ooh.
Oh, wow. Hydroplanes right into the laser. Percent?
Wow.
Forget him. Gibbous finally getting on board. Took 80. He has to be so cautious of the grab. And that's one thing I think Sass is going to be doing with the top as well, right? He's going to probably try to condition Gibbous into shielding. And if he shields a little bit too long, especially that close to Sassy, Sass is going to be getting his hands on him and getting that down throw up air. Great perfect shields, though, preventing such a grab from happening. Oh,
oh no.
Very tense. Very, very tense. Clipped by the back end of that nair, Gibbous finds himself in the corner, the top prevailing, but the nice delay makes him avoid the dare attempt from Sassy.
Ooh, there it is. Puts the top down, wow! Pushes him into him, and then there's the nair.
Yeah, and that top at that ledge, so dangerous. You can expect Sassy to use it to set up for some dares, potentially, and limit a lot of Gibbous' options for getting back onto the stage when he's on the ledge. Great patience from Gibbous. Clips him with the jab while Sassy was attempting to scoop him up with that up smash. Wow. Gibbous is doing a great job from an extra credit standpoint.
Waits at the edge. Anything for him? No, there's the Nair as he lands on top of him. Not getting it. Oh my goodness.
That was a great snipe, but he still has that Hydro Pump ready to go.
I like the fact that I'm seeing Sassy willing to go deep to potentially finish stocks.
Oh,
he's willing to take the risks, especially when you have P2P with Gibbous. Almost near, almost such 200%. It's unheard of.
Dude, no DLC needed. I think he's paying to win right now. Nair nearly taking him off, but Gibbous still somehow hanging out. That tombstone, however, is going to finally mean Gibbous' demise, but that was just his first stock.
He needs to make something happen. If he's going to do this, he needs to play immaculately from here on out. No damage.
Honestly, I feel like the top game is a big part of it. He's not, and on top of that, he's not getting as many of the follow-ups as he had in game one. Gibbous right now is really controlling the pace of the match, but there's the top that we were talking about before. Piling on some percentage, getting Gibbous to 40. I'm thinking about how much rage he has as well, right? Because that's going to mean it's going to be even easier for Sassy to get that KO. But at the same time, it might launch him too far for him to have a potential follow-up if the percent goes too high. Ooh, so scary. Nice getting the jab, trying to find the F smash. This is Sassy's chance. Down throw. Ooh, really smart by Gibbous. Jumping to avoid. Doesn't want to use that air dodge option just yet.
That's now that top coming out there forces Gibbous to have to go high as opposed to staying on the ground.
Yeah, Sassy has brought this back so nicely. Gibbous has to be so cautious. Gets clipped by the top from below. Nice shield. Doesn't find the follow-up after that jab, though. Sends him a little bit too far for him to connect with the F smash.
That's it.
No, wow, the drift. The drift. Gibbous, man, not even a sigh of relief. I feel like he's just pumped. I feel like he's pumped and he's amped, and he feels like he just wants to get into the next game as quick as he can, coast off of this momentum as much as he can to make sure he can continue on in this winner's bracket.
No character change. Going straight back into it. 3-64. Yeah, there it is.
I like it.
I know you like it.
At Paragon, they straight up like clapped the Dreamland 64.
Oh, we joined them.
It was great like the first time, and the second time, and the third time,
and the fifth time.
But after the sixth time, I was like,
oh, that's when you, because you were sick of hearing me like clap the fast part of this too.
No, I was okay with the fast part. Alex 19 was so mad.
Oh, yeah.
Shout out to Alex 19. That guy's hilarious. Anyways, game three. Gibbous on a bit of a deficit right now. I'm curious as to why Sassy chose this. The one thing that I'm thinking about is that top platform, though. That top platform is a bit closer towards the blast zone, which means that if he can get one of those grabs from there, then it's going to be even more devastating if he lands the Robo Hoo-Ha. On top of that, the other platforms are also elevated as well. So if he goes for the tombstone, then that could mean a little bit extra oomph. Maybe a potentially lower percentage KOs.
Okay, so Sassy. Oh!
Yo, that was a great read from Sassy. And especially in that situation, Gibbous couldn't really do much, given how much punishment you get for air dodging so close to the stage in this game.
He just cyclopsed that dude. Oh my gosh!
At first I was thinking, I mean, he's got two eyes, but then I remember, oh yeah, because Cyclops, like X-Men. Oh wow, high ceiling it. Oh, sorry,
he blinked at him.
That's coming in clutch. I was really surprised, you know, that's the one difference is with a character like Greninja, it doesn't necessarily possess the same oomph. Sometimes it's really surprising whenever KOs like that happen because you just don't expect it. But Gibbous has done a pretty good job of understanding which options will KO when. He's brought this back so that it's a really close game.
Definitely one of the more satisfying things to hit with is that up smash, especially, you know, once you have those higher percentages. I mean, having the read as soon as they drop down on that platform above you makes everything feel better. So forcing his way past these projectiles, fam. This is the other thing, right? Because you have so many projectiles constantly coming out there, and they're forcing themselves into your zone, you're thinking to yourself, I got a shield, I have to shield, I have to shield. And the more you shield, the more Sassy's like, bruh, let me show you what a crow looks like. And then you get beat boots.
Ooh. Oh, man, that's unfortunate for Sassy. Before the hit with most of the knockback happened, he landed on the ground, thus canceling out part of his attack. Jabs, forcing him onto the corner once again. Gyro coming in play. Gibbous, quite the deficit. Knows that Sassy at this point is probably fishing for that grab. So cognizant of it, but ends up running right into the grinder.
Wow. Showed up just on the other side. There it is.
Ooh,
good punishment.
Again. He's still somehow in this. Avoids the dare from Sassy. Sassy is so close to taking this. Can he do it?
He just needs to keep chucking projectiles.
I mean, he's definitely controlling the pace of this game. And look at him trying to find out when Gibbous is going to potentially be whiffing one of those shields. He knows that if Gibbous doesn't get the perfect shield on the top, then he has an opportunity to maybe get his hands on him. But Gibbous has been so great with his defensive game right now at such a high percent.
Gibbous has Sassy to the wall. Surrender space, but forcing his way back to the side. Edge guard opportunity.
Perfect shield game.
Ooh, no, too much.
He's off stage!
He's good!
What a dunk from Sassy.
He coming in clutch.
He overextended that one time, and that was one too many. He went out there and he said, you know what, I think I have something for you, and was sadly mistaken.
Sadly mistaken. That's a bit of a heartbreaker for Gibbous for sure. Did a great job of bringing it back. Couldn't clutch it out in the end, and Sassy, with a monstrous dunk, ends up advancing in our winner's bracket.
Looking like the Monstars.